boogie, caper, cavort, flit, frolic, hop, prance, strut. You must be thinking I'm talking Latin and Greek, but these are mere ABCDs for our guest tonight. And he actually believes in ABCD. Anybody can dance. Friends, let's welcome our very own Indian Michael Jackson, Remo D'Souza, on Starry Nights. Remo, welcome to Starry Nights.
Thank you so much, Komal.
You're not Remo.
No.
You're actually Ramesh Gopi.
Yes.
So how did you become Remo D'Souza?
I became Remo D'Souza, I think it's around 87, 88.
Mm-hmm.
I used to do a lot of shows for a church, Sacred Heart Church, and I'm from Gujarat, Jamnagar.
Okay.
So I used to go there and used to do shows for that. And I was very attracted to church and Jesus Christ. And I used to do Sunday Mass, 6 o'clock Mass during that time,
uh-huh.
School time. So
uh-huh.
Father Davis used to keep looking at me every time. And he knew that I was not a Christian, but still I used to go there and do so much work for the church. So he asked me one day that, why do you come here? And I said, I like it. I mean, I love coming here, attending Mass and all the stuff. So he said, why don't you convert yourself? So I said, give me a day. I'll come back with the answer.
You asked only for a day, huh?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I went back home and I told my mother and my father.
Mm-hmm.
My father's from Air Force, so it was very strict. But surprisingly, both of them said, what do you want to do? I said, I would like to convert. They said, go ahead, do it. Because my father was a big believer in Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
My mom was a big believer. So they said, okay.
But they didn't convert.
They didn't convert.
Convert only.
Yeah. So okay. In my family of 8 people, I am the only one who's Christian. Otherwise, everyone is Hindu.
Oh, but you observe Hindu religion also?
Yes, of course.
Alongside Christianity?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay.
Yes. I have Ganpati every year since last 16 years now.
Uh-huh.
I celebrate everything. I celebrate Eid also.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Wow, that's very nice.
Yeah.
And from liking masses or mass in the church,
mm-hmm.
to mass adulation. So yeah. When did the mass adulation begin?
That around, I think it began around when I came to, I think, Bombay.
Mm-hmm.
When I came to Bombay and...
Started. And you came with the set mind that you'll become a choreographer, or how did you come to...
So, yeah, this is something nobody knows, actually. Hmm. I didn't come here to get into industry.
Not at all?
No.
Okay.
This is the first time, actually, I'm telling this to
Good.
You.
Good.
I came here to meet Pooja Bhatt.
Okay.
Yeah.
You were a fan of Pooja Bhatt?
I was a huge fan of Pooja Bhatt.
Uh-huh.
Since all of films were... During my school days, I used to, like... mad fan, crush, everything you can say.
Uh-huh.
I had a room full of Pooja Bhatt's pictures.
Wow.
So my sister said, you only put pictures, you can't ever meet her.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, what if I go and meet her?
Uh-huh.
What will you give me?
Uh-huh.
She said, I'll give you a silver bracelet. So I said, okay,
mm-hmm.
give me, I'm in 10th standard, I'll finish the board exam and I'll go and meet her and then give me...
You didn't ask her for just one day like you asked the
no.
father.
And then I came here,
uh-huh.
and I didn't know her. Nobody here was here. I mean,
you didn't know anybody in the film industry?
Nothing.
Not at all?
Not even Bombay. I mean, mm-hmm. not even film industry.
Okay.
I never.
So this was the first time you were coming to Bombay?
First time Bombay, and no relation of mine, like ever, that I know somebody and I'm going to meet. No. I just landed
mm-hmm.
to Bombay.
Mm-hmm.
Called up to my friend in Jamnagar. I said, see, I've landed here.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know anybody.
Mm-hmm.
I remember when you were getting married, there were some guests from Bombay who came to visit you.
Uh-huh.
Can you give me their details? So they said, "Theek hai, I will give you, but make sure that you don't pile on them and like just sit on their head." And said, no, I'll go and just meet him. Just I need 2 days.
Mm-hmm.
So they gave me address. I met. They used to stay in Grand Road,
mm-hmm.
Chikkalwadi.
Mm-hmm.
First time I experienced Mumbai.
Mm-hmm.
that chawl and the chikalwari.
And you traveled by train? Traveled by the local train.
Yes.
And you bought a ticket? Because oftentimes, newcomers don't buy tickets.
No, no, I bought a ticket. Yeah. I told my mom that I'm going, and my mom gave me 2,600 rupees,
okay.
I remember.
Okay.
And she made a special pocket. Inside.
So that you don't get...
Don't get robbed. Yeah. This thing. So I landed here, met those people. To my surprise, and lucky me that they were very nice. Mm-hmm. And they said, "Ke, don't go here and there because this is Mumbai. You came here first time. Mm-hmm. Stay with us."
Oh, that was very nice of them.
Yeah. So I stayed with them. I just wanted 2 days to stay with them.
Correct.
But I ended up staying 5 years with them.
5 years?
Yes.
So you actually piled on.
Yeah.
Exactly. You did exactly what your friends asked you not to
do. Not to do. But I'm thankful to that family, Pardesi family, because I'm only because they gave me shelter. That's mm-hmm. why I'm here. I don't think so.
So obviously they must have taken a liking to you.
Yes, they.
And
they
what
really
is it that you did so that they started liking you and loving you so much?
I don't know.
Did you show them your dance moves?
No, never. I never showed them dance.
Okay.
But I don't know. I think they were very nice.
And what about your Puja Bhatt?
Then I met after 2 years. Mm-hmm. I was here 93, 94, 95. Uh-huh. I struggled. The struggle part was over. And then I got into film industry as a dancer, background dancer.
Background dancer, okay.
So that time, Sohail Khan was directing a film called Ozar.
Ozar. Mm.
And I was a dancer in that film.
Okay.
Background dancer. Mm-hmm. I was shooting and Pooja Bhatt came to visit the set. Uh-huh. That was the first time I met her. Uh-huh. And I ran to her and I said, "Listen, I need a picture." And that I couldn't speak because there were stars and mm-hmm. I was a dancer. Mm-hmm. So I have a picture with her. Mm-hmm. I clicked that picture. Uh-huh. Took that picture.
But did you tell her that you have come to Bombay only to meet her?
No.
Were too shy.
I was too shy and I was too scared also because... Mm.
She's such a big star.
Yeah, big star, and I was just... So bheed me that, you know, in the thing, I also went and clicked picture like a fan. So I took that picture back home, Jamnagar. Mm. I showed it to my sister. I said, "See, I met her. Where's my silver bracelet?" I got my silver bracelet and came back here and never went back.
How did you think of entering the film industry?
When I came here, there was nothing. I was staying with the family which gave me a place to live. I was 1 month was over and I thought, "Okay, I'm actually piling on to them. I'm not giving them anything and I'm not working and I'm just sitting there and eating their food and living with them." Mm. Then I said, "Okay, I have to give them something." So I said, "I should work here, but I don't know anything. So I only know dancing." Then I started my dance classes and then started earning little money, started giving them. So they also felt that this boy is working and now is doing something. Mm-hmm. And when I became dancer, then I got really good money per day. There was a nice money to get in. And then started giving monthly money to the head of the family. Mm-hmm. So then they were very nice. I mean, they were already nice, but then they said, "Okay, no, this guy is working."
He seems to be very genuine.
Yeah, yeah.
But back home, your parents did not object to your staying in Mumbai or Bombay that time, especially because you weren't doing anything.
They did. Uh-huh. 2 years, 3 years when I was doing nothing here. So they kept calling. My mother kept calling me and said, "Okay, you know, come back. Mm-hmm. You can't do anything there." And my neighbors and everyone, they were said, "Okay, what can he do there? And it's Mumbai and there were a lot of people and he's not even good looking and he's not even, don't know anything about film industry and he's gone to going there. So he's not going to do anything. Call him back." Mm-hmm. So my mother used to get scared. Talking
and your father?
My father was a little confident on me. Mm-hmm. He said, "Work hard. If you can't do anything, come back then.
The doors are open."
Yeah, yeah. The doors are open.
So but did you feel any time during your struggling days, did you feel that this city is not for you or this industry is not for you?
Yeah, initially, yes. Everyone feels that. But I came to know a term that Mumbai is a place where initially when a newcomer comes here, initially this place like tortures you and tells you tortures you in every way that you go back. Mm-hmm. You're not meant for Mumbai.
Correct.
So if you survive that period,
then it embraces you.
Then it embraces you.
Oh. So you knew this and therefore you decided you'd be here.
Yes.
But in your weaker moments or when you were down and out, whom would you confide in? You definitely needed a shoulder to cry on.
Yeah, so...
Would you cry?
I never, I never cried, actually. Achha, I do cry. I'm a very emotional person. I cry, but I never cry in front of
you. Cry in anybody. Hindi films?
I do. Yes. But I remember two films I cried on.
Which Hindi one? Films.
One is Dosti.
The Rajshri film.
Yes, Rajshri film. And the second film I cried in front of my wife was Swadesh.
Okay.
Yeah. So I cried and I went down on the chair so that nobody could look at me. So yeah.
And did your wife also cry?
Yeah, she cries a lot.
She cries a lot. She cries a lot. So you make her cry a lot.
Yeah.
What kind of a husband are you?
I can say I'm an average husband. I'm not a great husband.
Mm-hmm. I'm average. Why?
I think I'm too much into my work.
Okay. Okay.
I keep like I'm busy with my work and I keep doing. If I'm at home also,
you are.
I keep thinking of my work. I keep doing my work.
So then, doesn't she complain?
She does. She does every time. But then,
and so you're quite okay with it that she'll complain, but let her complain.
Yeah, but then. So now I think for a few years she said ki isse to kuch hone wala nahi. I mean he won't be able to do anything. She became my finance advisor and my costume and my everything. So she travels with me and now she understood now how to.
So now you're able to give her more time than you earlier did?
Yeah, now I can give her more time and she travels with me. And
so you're not a romantic at heart or you are a romantic who just doesn't have the time?
I am, I just doesn't have a time.
Yeah.
But if I have a time, then I can.
And what is the most romantic thing you've done in your life?
The first incident which was very romantic was when I proposed to her.
Mm-hmm.
I took her to the restaurant and made her sit and then champagne and the typical thing, the champagne glass, my ring and then put a ring and then said.
So how many months were you all seeing each other?
We saw each other for almost a year
and then we got
married.
Okay.
So yeah.
And you knew she would say yes or you were not sure?
I was not sure actually.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And what would you have done if you would have declined your proposal?
I would have forced her.
You wouldn't have given up. You don't give up easily.
No.
Naturally, somebody who could wait for 2 years to meet Pooja Bhatt.
Yeah, then you can.
So that was just Pooja Bhatt the star. This is your
life partner. Uh-huh. So.
But she said yes.
She said yes.
Mm-hmm.
And then this is almost now 17 years now.
So you joined the film industry as a dancer.
As a background dancer.
Background dancer.
Yes.
At that time, did you think that you would be a choreographer someday? Or what was in your head when you joined as a dancer? You just thought that dance karke hi is enough for me?
When I joined as a dancer, I knew that this is my world. I want to be here.
Okay.
I can't go anywhere else because this is what I wanted.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the place I got it. Now I can't go anywhere. So I have to be here, work hard and stay in this world.
But as what you were not
as
sure?
As what? No, not
sure.
Mm-hmm. So I became a dancer. And that was a big struggle to me because it was not easy to become a dancer also in this industry.
Correct.
During that time.
Correct.
So I became a dancer in a very filmy manner. And then...
Share that incident.
Yeah.
All those incidents.
So Rangila was...
Ramgopal Varma.
Ramgopal was making Rangila.
Mm-hmm.
And choreographer was Ahmed Khan for the first time.
Sure.
He was also first film. Ramgopal was Hindi first film. And they were looking out for new dancers this time. So if you remember, before Rangila, there were dancers, background dancers, but they all looked in a different, they had a different look. But after
when
Rangila
changed,
it changed. So this was Ram Gopal Varma and Ahmed Khan's idea to get college kids to dance behind actors.
Okay.
Like good looking boys and girls. Mm-hmm. So they were looking out for good looking boys and girls.
But your neighbor said you were not good looking.
I was not good looking. So I was coming there. So the audition happened.
Mm.
I gave audition. So I was not selected. So I said, why?
Hmm.
So I went to the assistant because Ahmed Khan took the audition. He went, he pointed out a few boys, which I was not there. So he went, he didn't know anything. So I went to the assistant, Sunita. I said, ma'am.
Why
have you left me out? He said, we all want understand we need good looking boys, fair and this thing. I said, you can't take me out without seeing my dance. At least see my dance. They didn't even see my dance.
Mm-hmm.
So Sunita said, "Acha, theek hai. Come, dance." And she made me dance in front of the gods of dance were all sitting. Longi and all these guys were sitting there. Like they were big dancers.
And they were known choreographers.
They were known choreographers. Yeah. So I danced.
Mm-hmm.
And when I danced, this was the only time I knew that if I don't perform here, this career is gone because I will not get selected and I'll be... So this was the chance. I danced and Sunita said, you're very good. Everyone clapped.
Fantastic. So much like Urmila Matondkar scene in Rangila, where she goes to...
Absolutely.
She rehearses all night with Aamir Khan and she says, kal mera screen test hai ya kal mujhe jana hai. So much like that.
So much like that.
Yes. And then?
Then Sunita picked up phone and she called Ahmed Khan and said, ke, we need 50 boys.
Mm-hmm.
49 you choose, one I'll choose.
Wow. This was something fantastic.
So that's how I got into this thing and so that's why I said it's a very filmy.
Damn good. And the rest, as they say, is history.
Yeah.
When you sign a film, sometimes do you feel ki this actor can't dance and to make, as a choreographer I'm saying, and to make this actor or actress dance is going to be a nightmare, so let me wriggle out of it. Have you ever had these thoughts? Because everybody is not a dancer. There are so many actors who dance with two left feet.
Yes. There are this thing, but this never happened with me.
Okay.
Yeah. You give me anybody and I'll make sure that he'll look good in that song.
Really?
Whether he can dance or not dance, but I will make him look good.
I can't dance to save my life. You can teach me dancing?
I will. I'll do a song with you then.
Okay, he told us
in camera now he's going to do a song with me.
And which is the actor you felt would be most difficult and you made him dance or her dance?
Sanjay Dutt. Kante. That Ishq Samandar song.
Yes.
And I said, I have to make him dance. And then he came and he said, what is this? And he's little on higher this thing every time he comes and says, I will not do this, I will not do that. I said, I'll show you slowly. Just see it. Okay, and then he started enjoying it. I mean, the simple, and then he performed really good in that song. And so I made him dance. I made Ajay Devgan dance in Cash.
Mm.
There was some moonwalk he did in that song. I know that film didn't do...
But he
danced well. Then I made Sunny Deol dance in Jo Bole Sonyal. Mm. So
you made real non-dancers also dance.
Yeah, so... Everything. Sohail Khan danced in one of the film, and he really danced in that song, so you can say that.
Hrithik Roshan, Tiger Shroff, these are really, really good dancers.
Absolutely.
But who, according to you, is the best dancer in the Bollywood today, contemporary times?
I would say Hrithik Roshan.
Hrithik Roshan?
Number one.
Better than even Tiger?
Yes, I would say number one.
And why would you say that?
We've not seen Tiger do a lot of things. Mm-hmm. Maybe he... in future, maybe he'll be...
But from what we have seen...
But what we have seen is definitely Hrithik Roshan, because when he does something, it looks amazing. And he's done hip-hop, he's done contemporary, he's done all kind of dance.
Mm-hmm.
And he's done it to the T. He's like that perfect. I've never seen a...
Better dancer
than Hrithik Roshan.
Really?
Yes. He's the best.
And if you were to compare him, Hrithik Roshan, with choreographers like yourself and others, what would you say?
I think he makes the choreographer look good.
In really?
Every song he does. Because if I do a step, and then if you see him doing step, it looks totally different. It looks wow.
There's a round of rapid-fire questions for you, Remo. You'll have to answer these questions, these five questions, in just yes or no.
Okay.
Do you get affected by critics' reviews?
Yes.
Have you ever tried to impress a girl with your dance?
Yes.
I'll break my own rule and say, who's the girl?
Well, she's my wife now.
Have you ever regretted saying yes to a film?
Yes.
Have you ever taken up a song only for money? Purely for money?
Yes.
Have you ever cried on a film set?
No.
Okay, now these next five questions are those questions where you have to answer in one word, not one sentence.
Okay.
Your one faltu moment?
I think I would say... When I got rejected, I would say,
rejected.
That was the biggest faltu moment I have.
The one song that makes you jump up and break into a dance.
Batmize.
That one female celebrity whose beauty makes you go bezuban.
Madhuri Dixit.
Hrithik Roshan or Tiger Shroff?
Tough one. Hrithik Roshan.
Now, these are questions, what if? So you'll have to answer.
Okay.
What if you went invisible for 24 hours?
I'll go places where I've never been and see what people are talking about me and just be there. Yeah.
Okay. What if you were a reality show participant, not a judge?
Then I would be very bad.
Why?
I think I see so much talent now. Mm-hmm. I think I'm nowhere close to any one of them.
You really think so? What if you had to choreograph a song with your wife?
She's very shy and she, right now, I mean, wherever the time comes and when I pull her to dance, she never dances. But yeah, I would love to make her dance one day. Yeah.
What if you traveled back in time and had the chance to work with Michael Jackson?
Oh my God, that would be... Now, if I get that chance, I'll cry in public also.
What if an actor hits on you?
I don't know how to react. I don't know how to react, maybe.
Remo, it was great talking to you. Thank you for being our guest on Starry Nights. But before you leave, we've got a certificate for you.
Wow.
Which really justifies what you have been doing and what you are. If you can show it to the to our audience.
Wow, amazing.
Just to certify that you rock and how. And we have a small little hamper as a token of our love. Wow. Thank you.
I love hampers. Nice. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
My father always wanted me to be a pilot. He sent me twice to give NDA exam. Went to the examination hall. I didn't write anything.
You didn't write anything because you weren't
because prepared? I didn't want
to. Oh, you didn't want to
I
become
didn't
a
want
pilot.
To become a pilot. Second time my father came with me so that I sit there and give my exam. He came, he stood outside my examination hall. I pretend that I was writing, but I didn't write anything.
Oh my God.
Till evening we danced and he said, you guys will be in front line tomorrow with the shoot. And we went for the shoot and we were at the last line.